Well, there's actually lots and lots of sources of mispricing or patterns of behaviour or business situations that we see over and over. One of the big ones is underestimating the returns that are going to come from a business for a variety of reasons. One of the reasons is, for example, when there's a store rollout going on, people can get focused on the existing business and not think so much about how big the store rollout is. In the case of Lovisa, for example, the share price came back from $12 all the way to $6 because people were worried about like-for-like sales in Australia. Australia was about half the business. Like-for-like sales ended up falling from about 5 or 6% per annum down at the worst point to maybe about minus 2. And that was because the whole of the Australian retail market came back. However, at the same time, Lovisa was growing its top line by almost 20% per annum because it was rolling out to the United States, to Great Britain, to France, and so forth. So that was a classic case of the market missing the wood for the trees, really. Another thing that the market often does is it misses big changes in consumer preferences. Now, Coca-Cola, for example, is really suffering from that because people want to have less sugary drinks in their life. And as a result, for 10 years, its earnings have struggled and the stock price has gone nowhere. It's traded between about $6 and $8, maybe up to $10 at the most, but has really been within that range for the last 10 years or so. So we've had a short on Coca-Cola and that's really gone nowhere while the markets run ahead. Another thing that it's we can get some easy wins sometime because the market just seems to make the same mistake over and over is pre-IPOs. So in a company called Telix, which is biotech, it had some near-term earnings, were able to buy it pre-IPO at about 16, 17 cents. It listed around about the 60 cent mark. It's currently trading about 85 cents.